Before we get into today's video, I just want to give you a quick reminder. I went out to Best Buy, purchased a brand new HD 60S, and I signed that bitch to give away to one of you guys. If you want to enter to win, there'll be a link down below in the description. Gonna be going till April 9th, so you have plenty of time to enter. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll be mailing it directly to you from me. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Drop a like if you do. Let's get started. So as of right now, it's all but confirmed from Activision themselves that the next Call of Duty game is going to be taking place in World War II. And with that information, a lot of you have been asking me over the past week or so, how would they do a supply drop system? How would it work in a World War II era game? We're going to explore all the possibilities and what could be in a World War II crate. And this is going to be a more open-minded, open discussion type of video. So please leave your thoughts in the comments section below. So first things first, for the people saying it's World War II, maybe they're going back to the roots. Maybe that means the supply drop system's not going to be there. In a perfect world, I would love that. It would be amazing. Just have all the content like it used to be back in the day where we would just purchase it for a one-time price, be done with it. I think if we went back to that model, a lot of people would be happy, including myself. But could you imagine having a DLC weapon release maybe every other month or something and it would cost $4.99? Would you spend $5 on a weapon, or would you rather there be crates and you have the option to possibly get it for free? That's a discussion for another video. But the thing is, they're making way too much money. There's no way the system's ever going away. And that's why it's up to us as the community to let them know what we like and what we don't like. And last year with Black Ops 3 is a perfect example of us as the community saying, yo, Activision, we know you're making money, but what the fuck? Don't forget about us. We're the community. We're what made you guys. And you know what? They have done the right thing with Infinite Warfare. Every range-based weapon has been obtainable for free, which is sweet. And Modern Warfare Remastered, super easy to earn the weapons. I don't mind how they've done it there. I even want to go out on a limb and say the Modern Warfare Remastered supply drop system is superior over anything we've ever seen. It's the perfect balance between, hey, if I want to spend some money, I'm going to get whatever I want, or hey, if I just wait and grind my ass off, I can get whatever I want. So you don't have to spend money because you have control where all the other games are just completely random, and that's the problem. So that's the first thing that I want to put on my wish list for whatever their supply drop system is in 2017. Please allow us to purchase whatever we want, whether it's a camo, a calling card, an emblem, if those even exist in the game. If we have the option to fast track and just buy it with parts or salvage or whatever, that's going to be good. But the biggest question is, what type of items would we see in a World War II supply drop? A lot of people were saying that customization would be really limited, and to an extent, I agree, but at the same time, we also have to remember we're playing a video game, we're playing Call of Duty, so they do have the option to do some stuff that's far-fetched, but at the same time, still within the realm of reality. So just think of it this way. Every soldier, no matter the war, we're just going to say World War II for this example, everybody has their own personality, their own characteristics, and that goes over to their loadout. No matter what the weapon is, a World War II soldier, for example, probably sitting in a trench or sitting in a bunker, staring at that same old government-issued weapon that they have every single day, they piss with it, they shit with it, they eat with it, they sleep with it, and then boom! All of a sudden, they want to start scratching into it. They start etching something into the wood grain, they start etching something into the metal or the barrel or whatever, and boom, there you go. There's your customization for weapons. It's subtle enough to where it's not going to be too distracting, like a tactical pink shotgun in the middle of the battlefield, but it's also cool in the fact that you can make it unique to yourself. So they could basically just put pre-made etchings in a supply drop system and you unlock, like, let's say the Grim Reaper, and you can etch the Grim Reaper in the side of your weapon. That would be really cool. I wouldn't mind having that at all. Taunts and gestures would be an easy thing to put into the supply drops as well. Infinite Warfare introduced gestures where you can give like thumbs up and thumbs down in-game while you're playing. Things like that would work, but it would have to stay within the realm of reason. Once again, you can't have a World War II soldier running around doing the horns to the heavens and expect it to look right, you know what I'm saying? Like, it needs to stay within, like, the gestures that happened in World War II. Same thing with the endgame taunts. You know, first, second, and third place, you can do little taunts and things like that. If somebody's sitting there dabbing, I don't even know what to think. You know what I'm saying? Like, if they're gonna have a dancing soldier, they better be doing the Charleston. That came out in the 1920s. I wouldn't mind seeing that. I think that'd be kind of funny, actually. And talking more about all this, I hope they allow us to choose between a gesture and, of course, a weapon inspect. It would be cool just to look at our weapons, especially if we can customize them with etchings and things like that. Another thing that Sledgehammer could do that would keep it really unique to this game, they could do customizable tattoos, or tattoos that are found within supply drops. Now, I know that that sounds really weird, but permitted that our characters have short sleeves on, we've seen tattoos on our soldiers before, and even in Infinite Warfare, if you play the Zombies mode, the higher fidelity game, the tattoos look really nice. They're really easy to see. You can see very finite detail in it, and I think that would just be another step of customization. Now finally, the last thing that I want to point out, and I guess this could be the same thing as a calling card or an emblem, but decals. Decals were huge in World War II. What could you apply a decal to? Maybe your helmet. Maybe you could apply it to your weapon itself. There were weapons that had decals on them, like that soldiers had customized, but it was far and few in between, so I don't really know if that's something that they would do. It kind of rolls into the conversation of weapon camouflage, because every World War II Call of Duty game that we had, there was never weapon camouflage in the games. Even World at War did not have weapon camouflage. So it kind of makes me wonder, in the day and age where people really love grinding camos and just love grinding in general, are they going to add camouflages that kind of fit that tone and that era, like olive drab and just straight up woodland camo and things like that? I'm not exactly sure what to think. This is a very interesting topic because it's not like camouflage didn't exist, but did it exist in the realm of everybody putting it on their weapons? I mean, for the sake of a video game, sure, why not? And at that, are they going to do secret camouflages like a diamond camo or a gold camo? I'm sure it would look really cool, but at the same time, it would be historically inaccurate. I mean, if anything, it is a video game. If they decided to do a gold camouflage, as long as it's shiny, like Black Ops 1 gold camouflage, and maybe if it was the top tier camo, like there wasn't a dark matter or an animated camo, because that would just look weird, but I think I would be fine with a gold camo. What about you guys? You think you'd be fine with a gold camo? Or even maybe a diamond? Let me know what you think down below. Maybe diamond camouflage just changes the accents of the weapon. It puts a little diamond on the iron sight. I don't know. But beyond all that, there's really not much more I would like to discuss at this point. I think that customization has the ability of being very broad, very wide, and plentiful. But at the same time, it depends on how they do it. Is it going to be tasteful? Is it going to be crazy? I'm not really sure. We are talking about Sledgehammer Games. Their last game was Advanced Warfare, which was really bright, really colorful, really crazy. But they're talking gritty, gory, and World War II setting. Things could get pretty crazy pretty quickly. So I want to see just exactly what we're dealing with here. Within the next few weeks, we're going to be getting teasers. I mean, we are in April. I can't wait to see some of them. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed the video today, click the like button. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And guys, thank you so much for all the continued support. Don't forget to enter the HD60S giveaway down below. And I'll see y'all on tomorrow's video. Peace.